Lord Jesus, we thank you for this beautiful day. We thank you for the freedom, the ability, the strength, and the church family that we have to be able to come together on a Sunday morning to worship and praise, honor, and glorify your name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. And please forgive us for the things that we take trust and obey because of the love that you have for us, your children. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. Merciful God, you made us in your image, with minds to know you, with hearts to love you, with wills to serve you. But our knowledge is imperfect, our love inconsistent and immature, and our obedience incomplete and self-serving. Help us today to go day by day growing in your likeness, which is so widely displayed in the diversity of creation. Help us to understand our own prejudices and narrow-mindedness. Help us to love our neighbor as we ourselves long to be loved. Help us to serve others with humility and gratitude. Do not hold our sin against us, but help us to repent endured hatred and, you know, just unjust things to a challenging point, but endured it for the next generation and allow us to have to do our, to carry out our journey, not having to. However, we know there is so much work more to do to align to the testimony of love that Jesus has taught us. So thank you. Thank you to those of you who have family members or indeed are part of the Windrush generation. Thank you. God honors you, God loves you, and God knows the sacrifice you all made. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. David now will come and read our scripture reading. Our gospel reading is from 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 to 21. Please may we all stand as we hear God's word, as we hear about his love. Let us stand and acknowledge our Heavenly Father who speaks to us in his word. Thank you.
God is love. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. Anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us and his love is perfected in us. By this we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he has given us of his Spirit. And we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son to be the Saviour of the world. Whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. So we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us. God is love,
Choose your family. So the storge is about family love. The next one is pragma. matures, it challenges, it endures. In this day and age, I think that the prevalent love has decreased. No longer does it endure. We get to a point where we're like, you know what, I can't take this, I'm out. It doesn't endure. The moment we hit challenge, maybe sickness, maybe it's difficulty, and things break down. But pragma is the love that endures. Now, I don't know if I'm going to pronounce this one correctly, but philautia is the next one. And this one is about self-respect, self-love. How well do you love yourself? The love and care that we give to ourselves. Now, I don't know about you. I'm my own worst critic. I get in the mirror and I can point out all the flaws in 2 seconds flat. All the flaws about myself, all the things that I think I don't know about myself comes to the forefront. But philautia is about self-love. How do you love yourself? Reflect on that. The next one is eros. That's the romantic, erotic love based on passion, attraction, magnetism, and romance. Eros. The next one, philia. Philia is shared experience. The love we feel for people we share a purpose or common goal with. Our co-workers, teammates, colleagues. One of you said you love your job. Is it a shared love that you have with your co-workers, teammates, those of you who are part of a team, a sporting team? That love that you have for your teammates and that togetherness is described as filial love. Now that's only 6 types that I've whistled through. And we've all expressed the different ways that we love, the things that we love. There's tough love when you're bringing up your children. And you might have to express a bit of tough love in order to teach them as they grow. They may not like it in the moment, but it's tough love because you know what is best for them in the long run. And I believe sometimes we experience, not sometimes, a lot of the time we experience tough love, we experience that love from our Father in heaven. How many times do we say, God, why me? Why is this happening to me? Don't you love me anymore? Don't you see me? Am I not here? Why are you ignoring me? Why don't you hear me? Do you not love me? You could feel that way.
Why are you making it so difficult?
Why is he making it so difficult? Has anyone felt that those kind of way? Anyone? If we're honest, if we admit to ourselves, there are times where we feel to ourselves, has God taken his hand off of me? Can God even hear me right now? Why is this all against me? Yet when we think about the parental love of a father to his children, of parents to their children, there comes this tough love where you may not understand. When you discipline a little child, all they know is that they want to do what they want to do. You know, they want to be free. my age will understand. When you have children, you will understand. There's a tough love that has to be happening. Because the Bible says, spare the rod, spoil the child. And so because we as adults know the bigger picture, through experience, through what we have been through, we then pass on those lessons to our children so that they don't have to. Now this is what happened with the Ringbosch generation. Through their experience, through all what they went through, they were able to pass on the lessons to their children so that they didn't have to endure it, or endure it with a better understanding of how to traverse the journey. Love, all of that, summed up in one word, love. Now the world's view of love is all very airy-fairy. Looking down the road, skipping, holding hands, hearts, you know, the big romantic love. Yet we can see the vast and various different ways of love that there is, which sometimes doesn't feel so positive, sometimes doesn't feel airy-fairy. Everything's going to be okay. The fairy tale love. When I was younger, I used to love reading, is it Sweet Dreams and Sweet Valley High, all these different novels about relationships, you know, two people not really getting on and then they get their prince in the end. The fairy tale love. I used to love all that. I love it. I'm one for the soppy love, romantic films, people. I love it. The cheesy romantic, as they say. But sometimes that's not the experience that we all have. And it paints a picture in our minds. It paints a picture. For me as a young child, it painted a picture of what love's going to be like. And boy, did I come to reality when I got older. But, you know, we paint pictures in our head, don't we, of what it should look like. Jesus. explained. Think about the tough love that I spoke about. The compassionate love. The different types of love. God is love. That was a whole different perspective and spin on the word love. When you think about love now, your perspective should be totally different in the fact of God is love. And those who abide in God, those who rest in His love, those who go into the presence of God, those who put God as the forefront, those who put God first and take His perspective of love instead of the world's, what the world tells us love should look like. Those who abide in God is love will know love deeper than you've ever experienced love before. So this morning, I just want to encourage you to try and let go of the narrative of love that the world gives us and go back to the love that the narrative of love that the world gives us, and go back to the love of God, which is explained in His Word. Because our understanding of what that love is determines the level of faith that we have. So if you're ever feeling stuck, if you feel that you're at a plateau in your relationship with God, you're feeling as though not moving forward. I always get to a certain point and I get stuck. It is because of your understanding of the depth of the God that lives in you. Once you get to a deeper level of your understanding of that love that resides inside of you, that will deepen your understanding of faith, and you will then start to go into a deeper spiritual level of your relationship with God. It's all about understanding the testimony and the narrative that I spoke about at a deeper level. And once we go deeper in our understanding, which is going into your word, understanding the walk in which Jesus took, understanding the way in which He dealt with people, the way in which He expressed love, the way in which He received love, the way in which He journeyed in the world. Take His narrative, abide in Him, communicate with Him, draw into His presence. Go deeper in your faith and come out of that rut that you may feel as though that you are in your spiritual relationship with God. God is love. And our understanding of love has to deepen. Our understanding of love has to take on a new perspective. Our understanding of love has to take on a new shape. In the way in which we express, in the way in which we receive. It is a learning thing, and we need to go to the Word and reshape our perception and understanding of love. Because in 1 Corinthians 13, verse 13, it reads, three things were lost. Faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Please may I ask you all to stand. as we express the love in which we have for the Trinity, for our Father, His Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. As we say together, we believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with His love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Please be seated as Doris comes and shares and leads us in prayer this week. Mary, come listen. Come listen. Peace right at the center as we hold Him in Peace between my conflicting selves.
Peace
of Christ above all peace. Peace between lovers and partners.
Peace
of Christ above all peace. Peace between parents and children.
Peace of Christ above all peace.
Peace between neighbors and nations.
Peace
of Christ above all peace. Peace in our church and our communities.
Peace
of Christ above all peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We're going to share peace slightly differently this morning. I'm going to ask you to stay in your seats and give everyone a sign of peace by either a wave or blow a kiss, as we're going to share peace today in that way. So the peace of the Lord be with you. Let us share each other. Peace be with you all. Peace be with you. Amen. As we get ready to sing our next hymn, please remain standing. We're going to sing hymn number 997, Jesus, Lover of My Soul. And during this hymn, we will take our collection. For those of you who don't do cash, if you have a card machine, please do indicate to Eric at the back, and he's able to take a donation if you would like to pay by card.
Thank you.
your promise, you pour out your Spirit upon us, filling us with your gifts, leading us into all truth, and uniting peoples of many tongues in the confession of one faith. Your Spirit gives us grace to call you Father, to proclaim your gospel to all nations, and to serve you as a royal priesthood. Therefore, we join our voices with angels and archangels, and with those in whom the Spirit dwells, to proclaim the glory of your name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy,
holy, holy,
holy
Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice paid once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day. When your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with St. Catherine and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we pray the Lord's Prayer. Being made one by the power of the Spirit, let us pray with confidence as our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
never stop growing in our understanding.
So please do come to the altar table to receive a deeper knowledge of that love that resides in you. If you would prefer a blessing, please cross your hands over your chest so I know to pray a blessing over you. You can leave it on the side. When you go to this side, you can go through to the Lady Chapel and light a candle. As you come through this side, as you go through the double doors, you can say your prayer and light a candle at the bottom. Hallelujah! Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah! Please do approach the altar. Lord, we thank you. We will never truly understand the depth of love it would take for you to sacrifice yourself on the cross for each one of us. Heavenly Father, as we acknowledge, and we do this every Sunday, Lord Jesus. Heavenly Father, may it not become routine. May we not take it for granted the privilege that we have to partake of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, who expressed his unconditional love to us as mere sinners. Lord, I thank you for the very specific, unique, and intentional love that you have for each one of us. That goes beyond anything our mind could comprehend, but Heavenly God, Father, may you continue to open our spiritual eyes and ears to understand the depth of love that you have for us, that would cause you to sacrifice yourself on the cross when you didn't have to. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And we say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Notices for us, church family. This evening we have evening song at 6 p.m. For those of you who would like to come and join us, 6 p.m. evening song. This Wednesday coming up, actually I don't even know what date it is. What date is it on Wednesday? Oh, hey! Hey! Wednesday, 28th of June, there is Wednesday Fellowship. Now, this is a fellowship group. For those of you that don't know, I serve my curacy at St. Mark's Church in Kensal Rise. And they run a Wednesday Fellowship group for, I would say, the over 50s, where they meet together, they fellowship, we share the word, and have a good time. It's a joyous time. And I will be running their session this week, and so have invited any of you all, if you would like to join us, you can do. The church is St. Mark's Church, which is run Bathurst Gardens in Kensal Rise. Session starts at 2 p.m. We have a talk session, and then we share tea and coffees afterwards, and just fellowship together, which is the name of the tin, really, truly, Wednesday Fellowship. So you're welcome to join if you would like to on Wednesday. Following that, on the same day, at 6:30 p.m, we have our regular prayer meeting here at 6:30. A time where we come together, we pray in the Spirit, and we seek God for all things that we want to give to Him. If you have anything personal you would like prayer for, if you would like prayer for healing, pray for deliverance, pray for your family, pray for yourself, pray for friends, whatever you want to lift up to the Lord. Wednesday at 6:30 is a time that St. Catherine's Church family come together, unite in prayer. I lay hands, I anoint. It's become a session of true encountering of the Spirit, entering in the presence of God and laying all at His hands. This church rests on the foundation of prayer. We are led by the Spirit. It is not anything to do with me. God uses me as a vessel. He speaks through me. And so I surrender all to you. Taking out anything that I may think for myself. And the way I do that is to humble myself in prayer. And so on Wednesdays at 6:30, this is what we do. You're welcome to come and join us in person. If you're unable to, what I ask is that you stop wherever you are and pray at 6:30, and our prayers will be united together in Spirit. Amen. likes for you to celebrate many more birthdays. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Right. Now, ooh, my favorite bit. You all know how I get excited about this now. Vows of marriage. I'm going to read the vows of marriage. Shall receive. stand as we sing our final hymn. Sorry, I've run out of time a little bit, but whoever the Spirit leads, it leads. It's a loving day today. Please stand as we sing our final hymn, "To God Be the Glory," number 708 in your books.
Spirit.